was my bag I always used for my trips when I was a flight attendant. On the back, it has like a little flap that slides down over the top of your luggage handle. So it's super convenient. Bagalini bags are like made to last. This thing is almost 10 years old and it looks like the day I bought it. Well, my grandma bought it for me as a gift when I became a flight attendant. Bagalini, the brand, was designed by a flight attendant, so they're really good for traveling. So let me start pulling stuff out of here. There's like a little mini zipper pouch on the front, and I'm gonna start there. There's just one, well, two. There's two things in there. First thing is this. It's just a quartz crystal. It's like a heart. I just like to carry this with me. This is from my great aunt, and it's just kind of like a comfort, like a, almost like a fidget, but it's just like very comforting for me. I like to hold it, and if I feel anxious or stressed, it just helps me, and I just like to have it with me. And I can also kind of just like, you know, hold it in my hand and move it around and stuff, and I just like it. It's my little heart crystal. And then I've got a, this is my lucky little sloth. She goes where I go. She always goes with me. She always lived in this bag when I was a flight attendant, and I took her on every single trip with me. If my husband or I have something important going on, like a big day, like an interview, or I don't know, a ceremony or something, we take it with us. I'll slip it in his pocket, or I'll take it with me in like a different purse or whatever. But yeah, she's just a lucky little sloth. It was a gift from my husband a long time ago, and I just love it. Alright, so now we're into like the big center compartment. So of course, first I have my wallet. It's a good size. It's just a normal size, but it can also be like a purse itself. It has a strap that goes with it. It's in the back somewhere. I'll find it. And it attaches here and over here, so you can wear it like a crossbody. This is by Mahalo Cases. I love, love, love that brand. Check them out if you've never checked them out. You can find them online at mahalocases.com. I just think they're a really good brand, and they have fun designs and everything. They sell these little, these are attachments you can buy to put on your wallet, and it's a charger. If you're in, you know, like desperate need of charging, it's really handy. It's come in handy for me a few times. My medication is in here. I did want to say, if you have medication that you like, you know, need to take all the time, never put it in your checked bag. Always, always, always keep it with you. I cannot tell you the number of times when I was a flight attendant, a passenger would realize like halfway through the flight that their medication that they need to take right now is in their bag that's under the airplane. And there is literally nothing we can do in the air to get that bag out from the cargo compartment. Like, it is down there and we cannot get out to get it. So also, like, if your luggage gets lost, you don't want your medication to be, you know, lost somewhere, so keep it with you. Mine's in here. It's always in here, actually. Even when I'm not going on a trip, I keep it in my wallet, because if I leave the house, I always have this. And if I'm in the house, then this is in the house with me, so it's just a good place for me to keep it. Okay. I've also got sunglasses. This is just like a pretty gold and white case. I think just like neutral. They go with everything, so I take them if I'm traveling. Okay, and then I've got, let's see. This is like a bag of chargers. This bag was a gift, from my mom a long time ago. And I just love the color. Like, this gold is so cute. Okay, so I've got regular phone charger that also charges my AirPods, which are right here. So there's my AirPods. And then I've got this is a charger for my iWatch. I always bring my iWatch when I'm traveling because it has the alarm function on it to remind me to take my medication. This is really helpful for me in like different time zones because I'll forget, you know, like, oh, in Kentucky it's 5 p.m. Like, I need to take my medication, you know? So, I always take my iWatch traveling because I can set the alarm to vibrate on my wrist when it's time for me to take my medication. My laptop charger. My laptop's actually not in this bag. I keep it, there's like a little pouch on my roller bag where I keep that. This is just an external charger. This is a really good one. It can charge like four devices. And it's by Mophie, Mophie. Love this one. It was like $100. It was a gift from my parents when I became a flight attendant. And oh my gosh, it's been so useful. It is over 10 years old at this point. And it works like the day I got it. It's so good. And then I've got this. This is my phone case that goes with that wallet from Mahalo Cases. And this one is magnetic, so it magnetizes inside of the wallet. I love to use this when I'm traveling because it literally sticks to my wallet. So, like, I don't have to worry about it like falling out or anything. And then this is the charger that charges my external charger. And then, okay, I know I'm a dork. You're gonna laugh. But these are for my AirPods. This goes around the AirPods, and then you can, you know, put it behind your neck and put them in, or I guess you could leave it like this. I don't know, but always use this on the plane because another thing, I cannot tell you how many times when I was a flight attendant, a passenger would lose one of their AirPods and never to be seen again. It just falls out or they drop it or whatever, and we literally never find them. The plane eats them. I don't know where they go. But I tell you what, I'm not, that's not happening to me. I am not going to be having to buy another pair of super expensive AirPods because I've dropped one on the airplane. So I will sit there and I will look like a dork with my little string sticking out of my headphones. And that is perfectly fine with me. I'm just putting some of this stuff back so that we have space to keep unpacking my giant travel bag. It's funny because a lot of people, when you're a flight attendant, they assume, like, oh, you must love to travel and you must be, like, so good at traveling and it must be so, you know, easy for you and whatever. And I'm like, no. No. I absolutely despise traveling as a passenger. I think it's horrible. It's like the worst experience. I am better at just like going with the flow, rolling with it. having worked that position, like, I understand there's literally nothing that can be done. It just is what it is. You have to go with it. There's no point getting upset because it's just, it is what it is. Traveling is just full of, you know, unexpected surprises. But no, I don't like traveling at all. At all. I do not like traveling as a passenger. It's stressful and, yeah, it's just, it is what it is. Okay, so this is my toiletries bag. This is, believe it or not, the same size as a quart Ziploc. I've never had any trouble traveling with this, so I always do, but I always bring a quart Ziploc bag, like the TSA says, in case they're like, it needs to be in a Ziploc bag, and then I can just put all this into the Ziploc that I have with me, and everyone's happy. I've never had to do that though, so it's all my toiletries. There's so much stuff in here. So let's see. I've got trying to find everything from this section. Let's see. What else? Okay. So this is all like makeup that is liquid that I can't just keep in my makeup bag because it wouldn't make it through TSA. So I've just got, these are lip glosses. They're from Bath & Body Works. And then I've got this LA Colors lip gloss. And this CoverGirl Yummy Gloss. This is a mini setting spray. It's LA Colors setting spray. My mascara. And, a concealer. I actually, when I'm traveling, I use this as both concealer and foundation because I don't want to bring a big foundation bottle. So that's like all my makeup that has to travel in my liquids bag. And then I've got, these are little perfumes. So these are from Dime Beauty. I just recently did a Dime Beauty order. I'm going to do like a video where I review all these and tell you about what I got, but I'm taking these two little mini sample ones with me. This one is I Love Your Smell Baby, and then Malibu Night. So I'm just taking these with on the trip, and then this is a little roller ball of lavender oil. I used to get these at this Westin Hotel that we used to stay at in Chicago when I was a flight attendant, and you just open it and then can roll it all across your pillow so that it's like nice and lavender scented. So I'm just taking that with. And then there's so much in here. I've got Sally Hansen nail polish. This is just like a sparkly, it's Diamond Strength No Chip, and it's called Pulled Sugar. Pulled Sugar, Pulled Sugar. That's a cute name. Okay, so then I've got peppermint oil. I always bring this. When I was a flight attendant, this lived in my bag because it helps with headaches. If there's any yucky smells, you can get rid of it with this. During COVID, like that whole 2.5 years we were flying with masks on, I would drop a few drops of this in my mask and it would just like help me stay awake and feel refreshed and get rid of headaches, and it's good stuff. I love it. Also, this is a flight attendant trick. It's kind of gross, but sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do if you end up needing to desperately use the bathroom on the airplane. Like you can't hold it and it's just like, I gotta go to the bathroom. You can drop a few drops of this like into the toilet, sort of like poopery, that spray, and it totally like deals with any smells that might be coming from the bathroom. So that's good to know too. Okay, so what It's just for anxiety. Like with everything, I have asked my own healthcare provider about this, and she is comfortable with me taking it with other things that I take. But you should always, always, always ask your own doctors, before taking anything like this. Even over-the-counter stuff. This is just from, you can get this at Kroger. That's where I got it. But just always ask your doctor. Make sure it's not gonna interfere with anything else you take or not be good for you for some reason. Okay, so I've got a. This is triple antibiotic. I don't know where this is from. It might be Dollar Tree. I think it's Dollar Tree. It's just, it's similar to Neosporin. It's like a knockoff of Neosporin. I just like to bring this with me. I have a lot of bug bites right now. It's summer in the south, you know, there mosquitoes are just everywhere, so I have a lot of bug bites, and I like to put that on them before bed, so that's why I have that. Okay, so then this is a travel bottle, and it is full of my hair oil. I use, what do I use? I can't even think right now. I use argan oil in my hair. After I shower, I use a detangler and then I put argan oil in my hair, and that's what this is. I just took it out of the bottle and put it into this little one. And then, let's see, this is my eye cream. It's just the Viche Mineral 89. It's for your eyes. Like, it goes around this area and like on your lid. And then let's see, what is this? Oh, this is my body wash. It's Dr. Bronner's tea tree soap. Soap, 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 soap. And then I've got sunscreen. This is the CeraVe Ultralight Moisturizing Lotion for normal to oily skin. And I've got my face lotion that I always use, Shea Moisture Papaya, and vitamin C with yuzu lemons. It's called Brighter Days Ahead Moisturizer. As you can see, I've almost used all of this. So, I'm gonna have to get some more soon. But it's perfect to take with me. On my trip, maybe I'll use it all up there and I won't have to bring it back. I don't know. We'll see. But it is 3.2 fluid ounces. So it is 0.2 fluid ounces under the limit, the TSA limit. So I'm good. I'm good to go. Another tip is, even if, say, you have like a bottle like this that's over 3.4 ounces, but you've used like a lot of it, they don't care. It doesn't matter to them that it's not full. They're gonna count it as more than 3.4 ounces and they're gonna take it away from you. So, it's just good to know. Okay, so then I've got my serum. It's the Shea Moisture Papaya and Vitamin C Brighter Days Ahead Serum. It just goes with the lotion. I put this on first and then the lotion. I have another serum that I like to use at night when I'm out at home, but I don't want to be bringing every, you know, thing I use when I'm traveling, so I just brought this one. And then this is a lip balm that came with that set. It's the Brighter Days Ahead lip balm. So I just brought that one as well. Okay, and then this is my hair detangler. I just took it from the bigger bottle and I put it in this little one. And I actually mixed it with some water because in this type of spray bottle, it sprays out better if I mix it with a little bit of water. And it doesn't really affect how the product works. I think it still works the same. So, that's just what works for me. I've discovered that trick when I was a flight attendant. I just still use it. Okay, so this is some lotion. This is, why can't I think of it? It's Palmer's. There it is. Palmer's Cocoa Butter Lotion. I just took it again from the bigger bottle and put it in here. This whole little travel set is from Target, and I highly recommend it. Works really good. I don't know what the brand is because it's not written anywhere on here, and I got it so long ago. I don't know. This is a little pot that came with the travel set, and I actually have hydrocortisone cream in here for the bug bites. I had like a big tube of hydrocortisone. It was more than 3.4 ounces, so I couldn't bring the tube, so I just squeezed it into here. Okay, and then I've got this is shampoo, and then this is conditioner. It's shampoo by Shea Moisture. It's the Manuka Honey Shampoo and Conditioner. And then I have my husband carry the toothpaste in his liquids bag because I just don't have any more room. And he has like tons of room in his liquids bag, so he carries the toothpaste for both of us. We do share a tube of toothpaste. I was unaware that that is weird, considered weird. I don't know. I grew up all the people in my family share toothpaste tubes with their spouses, and I never thought that that was weird until a friend of mine, like I was talking about like the toothpaste being in my husband's carry-on or whatever, and she was like, "Ew, you share toothpaste tubes with each other." And I'm thinking, yeah, I didn't know that was weird. So to me it's not weird. Sorry if it is weird to you. That's just how my family's always we've always I mean, I shared toothpaste with like other family members, like my parents, and I don't know. That's just how we do it. So I'm trying to put all this back in here. It's really full, but I need the space on my desk so I can keep showing you guys what is in the rest of this bag. Okay. So, I've got a pen. You should always, always, always have a pen when you travel, especially if you're gonna go international, because there's always paperwork you need to fill out on the airplane, in order to enter other countries. Also for Hawaii, they require an agriculture document that you have to fill out. So a pen is always a good idea. Okay, I have my little compact mirror. I love, love, love this one. This is one of my favorites. I'm just bringing that because if I need to like touch up my makeup or anything. Then I have like a tiny nail file. I've got these ginger rescue tablets. This is for like heartburn or upset stomach. It just, is good for me to have if I get like an upset tummy or if my husband needs some. It's similar to like taking Tums, except that it's ginger. And this just works really good for me. This is like a little note pad. It's got a pen in it. My husband got me this a long, long time ago, and I love it. It's got the prettiest pattern. And I just like to have it when we're traveling. I can make notes if I need to. So that's everything from like this little side pockets inside and the center part, and then I've got another zipper on the inside. And in there I've got these Colgate Wisp Max Fresh. And they're sort of like mini toothbrushes. It's like mouthwash inside of this little ball right there in the middle. And then you can use this end as like a toothpick if you need to. I like to have these when I'm traveling in case there's unexpected delays, stuff like that. And you just need to like freshen up your teeth. We don't have like an official will. We haven't like seen a lawyer and had like a real will made or anything, but we wrote down like what our wishes are if something were to happen to both of us at the same time. It is written down what we want done, and it is written down who we want to take care of our affairs, like who we want to take our baby dogs, Archie and Winnie, what happens with our money, all of that stuff is written down, and we trust the people, you know, that are written down on this paperwork, and all of our family members, everybody we trust to honor our wishes, even though it's not like a formal will. And then, let's see, oh yes, we've got my engagement ring and my wedding ring. They are from a store that is only in the Washington area where we moved from. So whenever we go back there, we have any service that needs to be done to my rings taken care of then. And we need the paperwork so they know, because we have a, what's it called? It's like a program you sign up for when you buy the ring. And it's like a lifetime guarantee that they do any repairs or necessary cleaning, stuff like that. So we need the paperwork to prove that, you know, we purchased that service. So that's all in there. And then I've got my little planner. It's just a tiny one that I bring in my purse. It's got puppies so that don't forget what I'm supposed to be doing on which day, stuff like that. Okay, and then couple more things. These are like entertainment items. I've got a book. A book. Of course I do. So this is J.R.R. Tolkien. This cover. Have been wanting to read this again, and I'm gonna take it with, and I'm gonna read it on the airplane. It's 5 hours about there, and then about the same coming back, so I should be able to get through the whole thing. And I mean, maybe I'll have some time just like before bed, you know, to do some reading. But I absolutely this story. It's so cute. I love the book so much more than the movie series. I thought the movies were what is the word? Just kind of slow, I guess. Slow moving. I get kind of over the battle scenes. I'm kind of just like, okay, I get it. We're fighting. Let's get on with the good part of the story. Okay. So then, I've got a tiny coloring book. I just like to have something to do, like, even if maybe there's just some downtime, like, on one of the days, you know, I can have something to do. Do a little coloring. There was a chicken page in here that I wanted to show you guys. Look at this. Oh, he's a rooster. Look at this rooster. I wanna do the rooster next. Okay. And then I think this is the last item. It's in this bag because it's a little bit easier to like pack versus the cardboard box can kind of crumple and like fall apart. It's just a 24 pack of pencils, and then I've got a little sharpener, pencil sharpener in there as well. A passenger on one of the airplanes I was working on gave me this little yellow pouch. So sweet, so cute. It was full of she sold eyelashes, like fake eyelashes, and she gave all the flight attendants these free samples in these cute little bags, and that was so sweet. I don't wear false eyelashes because I can't stand the way that they feel on my eyes, and so I actually gave all the eyelashes that were in here to one of my other crew members who was working on that flight, and she was thrilled because I think there were like 4 pairs in each bag. So when I gave her mine, she had 8 pairs, and she was really happy. And I was just really happy to.